In this video, we will try to understand how to design machine elements subjected to eccentric loading. So let us first try to understand what is the concept of eccentric loading. So as shown over here, we are having the load P, which is acting at a certain distance E away from the axis. So this particular E is known as eccentricity, and the load which is acting at a certain distance away from the axis of the member is known as the eccentric load. So P is the eccentric load and E is known as the eccentricity. Now we can draw the equivalent figure for this particular arrangement. So first we have shown the original load P acting at a distance of E. Now we'll add a load P in the upward direction as well as in the downward direction. So the resultant of these two force system will be zero, and we can say that these two systems, that is this original one and this one which we have modified, both are same. Now we can show this particular loading in the given fashion. So first we'll represent this load P, which is acting in the downward direction along the axis, plus, and this particular load as it is acting along the axis will produce a direct stress. So direct stress is force upon area, plus. Now we'll consider the other two loads which are remaining over here. So we know that we have to draw this particular upward acting load which is remaining, and this is the another downward acting load which is acting at a certain distance E away from the axis, that we have to show over here. So the given particular arrangement is equivalent to this first figure plus the second figure. So in the first figure, as the load is acting along the axis, it will produce only the direct stress, whereas in this particular case, this particular arrangement will produce the bending moment, and therefore it will produce the bending stress. So bending stress is given by M upon Z, and the bending moment is force multiplied by the eccentricity, that is E. So it is P into E divided by the Z, that is nothing but the section modulus. Now let us see how it is producing the moment. So here we have shown this force system. So this downward acting force is P, this upward acting force is also E, and the distance between these two is E. Now we know that in mechanics we have seen two equal unlike parallel forces, they will produce a couple, and the moment of the couple is given by force multiplied by the couple arm. So E is nothing but the couple arm. The arrow of this particular force will go in clockwise direction towards this particular another force, or even if you consider this force, the arrow of this force will again go in the clockwise direction. So it is producing the clockwise moment, and moment will be equal to force multiplied by the couple arm, that is eccentricity E in this particular case. So in place of moment, we have substituted P into E. Now the resultant stress because of this particular eccentric load is nothing but direct stress plus or minus bending stress. So we have to use plus or minus sign, because the bending stress, if it is of tensile nature, then it is considered as positive, and if it is of the compressive nature, then it is considered as negative. The conventions will always depend upon the applications. So we can say that the given particular arrangement is subjected to the direct as well as bending stresses. So in conclusion, we can say that the eccentric load will always produce direct and bending stresses. So let us see with the help of example how we can apply this concept for the design of the C-clamp. So here we have shown a C-clamp. The cross section at certain section is also shown over here. Suppose P is the load and the cross section over here is having the width of B and depth of T, and it is assumed that B is equal to 3 times this particular thickness. From this axis of the cross section up to the point of application of the load, the distance is known as the eccentricity, that is E. So this is the eccentric load. This load is not acting at the along this axis of this particular member over here, or along this particular cross section, and hence it is the eccentric load. Now, as far as our formulas that we have used in our strength of materials, they are concerned, the horizontal dimension is known as width B, and that is equal to 3T in this particular case, and vertical dimensions, they are known as D, and that particular dimension is T in this particular case. So this is very, very important, because whatever the formulas that we are going to use for section modulus, they will be on the basis of this B and D. So So first let us find out the area of cross section. So area is, as this is a rectangular cross section, area will be equal to B into D. P is nothing but 3T and D is nothing but T. So 3T into T, that is 3T squared. Then as this particular eccentricity is measured from y axis, we'll have to consider the formula for section modulus of the rectangular section about yy axis. So it is 1 by 6 dB squared. Substitute the values of D and B over here. So value of D is nothing but T and value of B is 3T. So if you simplify this, 3T square bracket square will be 9T square. So it is nothing but 3 by 2 T cube. Then as we have seen, moment is nothing but force multiplied by the perpendicular distance. So force is P and perpendicular distance, that is nothing but the eccentricity in our case. So P into E is the moment that is produced. Now direct stress is equal to force upon area. So force is P and area is 3T square. Similarly, bending stress is M by Z. So Z is 3 by 2 T cube that just now we have calculated. Then resultant stress will be equal to direct stress plus bending stress. So our design will be on the basis of maximum value and hence we are using only plus sign over here. Now substitute the value of direct stress as well as bending stress over here. Direct stress is nothing but P upon 3T square, whereas bending stress is nothing but PE upon 3 by 2 T cube. This 2 will go in the numerator, so it is twice 2 times P into E divided by 3T cube. This 3T cube is the LCM. So, and here we are having only 3T square term. So, we'll have to multiply by T over here to this P. Now, cross multiply by this 3T cube to this resultant stress. So, it will be 3T cube into sigma R is equal to PT plus 2PE. In other words, we can say that transfer both these particular terms on this side. So we are getting the third degree equation. We can solve this on our calculator to get the value of T. Once we get the value of T, we can easily find out what will be the value of B. So in this way, we can design a machine element which is subjected to the eccentric loading. Thank you very much for watching.